Dude, what is this?
Oh my gosh, man. Bro. That's... Don't even hate. Look at this. Yes, guys. Welcome, Jamie Gonzalez.
I'm Chad Stoker.
Episode 2. We're going to get right into it. So we were watching the AMMO video.
Of his new system.
Guys, we did it. It's finally here. The all-new AMMO polishing system.
But guess what I just got in the mail? You haven't seen it. I haven't seen it, but it came in the mail.
Oh, you got it?
Bro.
Like, bro. Did you?
Bro. Mm. Let's, dude. The first thing we're going to open up is these waffles.
Waffles.
Bro. Look
at
this. No, wait. Look at this, though.
That's crazy.
Like, that's insane. Like, look at the...
Yeah, dude, his packaging, his marketing is second to none. I mean, that is just a sexy, sexy package.
This needs to be like in a salon.
In a museum somewhere.
I know everyone would call it, it's an auto spa, but...
The boutique,
bro,
it's
like,
brand.
This is a boutique brand. Yeah. Dude, it's so dope.
It is.
Look at all the products.
I'll tell you, I don't... I don't love not being able to see the pad, though. That's... First knock, but the packaging is sick.
I don't know what it, so it comes with a few pads. So there's one, two. I think it comes with four pads. So it comes with two waffle pads, and it also comes with
some more pads.
Look at this. Look at that. Wool pads, dope. Look at cool marketing in the back.
Man, those
AMMO, this is insane, dude. Look at that.
Those are interesting. That
can you see that good?
That shape.
There you go. That is insane.
That shape is crazy,
bro. But look at that. So I guess I don't know what kind of mix. Do you know what kind of, what does it say on here? You want to find out what this is?
Well,
also comes with some really nice edgeless microfiber. But really what
the whole kit.
The whole kit, dude. Check it out.
Exfoliate.
This is what's in here.
You want to exfoliate in 3 to 4 concentric circles.
Exfoliating is funny, bro. Like when someone says that, let's exfoliate your paint.
Bro, these pads have an interesting design. I don't know how I feel about them.
I don't know. I like the edges. It has like a little beveled edge. It's kind of cool.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is, but dude, what is this?
Oh my gosh, man. Bro. That's,
don't even hate. Bro. Look at this.
You better hide that or that's going home with me.
Man, look at that. Dude, it even has his autograph on there.
Ooh. Damn. I love these pen lights.
Hold on, let me hear. Dude, that is sick, bro. Dude, I don't even want to use this. Let's see.
You better
hide
it.
There's no batteries in it. Goddamn. Hey, AMMO, what's up? You cheaping out, bro?
How much you spend on this kit?
Come on, baby. You can't give me a couple batteries?
Are you sure it's not in the package?
I don't know.
I bet you they're behind this.
So, and we got some... We got more exfoliating polish fluid. This is dope. Look at that.
I wonder.
And, dude, this is extra sick, dude.
I'm so
stoked about
that. That bag is dope.
Look at that. God damn, dude.
God damn.
Damn, bro. This is heavy duty, too.
Bro, I'd buy the kit just for this scan grip light.
It's a scan grip?
Yeah, it's a scan grip. I wonder, this is exactly like the Rupes ones. I wonder if scan grip makes theirs.
Scan grip?
Yeah. It says right on there.
Dang, bro.
Yeah, you better put that away or that's coming home with me.
Here, you open it. You pull it out. You got the better angle. Rupes. Everything.
Bro, I've unboxed like 100 of these polishers. You would think that I would know how to do it by now.
Oh, my gosh.
I don't even want to take it out of the wrapper,
bro,
though.
That is so sick, dude.
How long do you think it's gonna take to get that dirty though? I mean, that is
no, you don't use that, bro. That's not. We're not. I didn't buy that to use it. I'm gonna use it, but
you ain't gonna use it. Don't use that.
This is so sick. 21. I'm not a 21 guy, but I take it. You know.
Why don't you like the 21? I mean, I'm with you, but
I just don't like it just because of harder to reach areas.
Yeah,
and it's like. I guess if you're just working hoods, big panels, this would be the thing to go with. But for me, it's not the throws. Maybe they're too powerful, I would say.
So let's talk about that. That just came to my mind because there's a lot of people that
I feel like they're too powerful. But I'm pretty sure there's some science behind that.
Actually, the 21 and the 15, at least the Rupes, the 21 does not remove paint any quicker.
Yeah.
The 21 does not remove paint any faster than the 15. And if you look at the schematics of the diagram of the RPMs or whatever on the front of it, you can see the 15 has more RPMs to it. So they actually remove paint. And this is just what Jason Rose has told me. They remove paint at the same depth, essentially. So this removes more paint, just the path. But as far as depth, this doesn't remove any quicker. But, I mean, there's so many different thoughts on that.
And see, like I said, it's just a comfort thing for me.
Yeah.
Maybe that's just... Because it's another thing, too. When I'm polishing with the rotary, I like a big-ass pad. Yeah. I like a big wool pad. I don't like... I guess if you're doing smaller edges or whatever, then I'll go ahead and use, you know, a smaller pad, at least on a wool. But for me...
Unless you're doing boats or RVs, I personally don't know why you would reach for a 21. Like, if you're doing big flat panels, okay, 21's the way to go. But other than that, like, 15s are just so much smoother. And again, you're not gaining anything power-wise.
Is this backer different?
It's a different color. Yeah, the Rupes ones are blue. Blue. So oh, yeah, yeah. One thing which is going to cause some issues for me, because... Like the blue ones, when they need to be lubricated or you don't have enough lubrication, you start to get that black marking. Yeah. You're not going to get that on that. So unless you're really paying attention to the lubrication on there, man, you're not going to. And that's an integral part. People don't realize that shroud, like people hate on that the shroud makes contact with the backing plate, but that is specifically designed so that it pulls air through the pad.
I know, but people when they're polishing, they don't like it. And this is just me when I'm polishing. The reason why I don't like it, and people get like the adapter.
Mm-hmm.
What is it called? I don't know. They put the washer.
Yeah.
The washer mod.
Yep.
Yeah, whatever. Washer mod. What a corny ass name, bro. Anyways. So when they put the washer mod, or people just chop it up. For some reason, me looking at that just when I'm polishing, I feel like I'm breaking it.
Yeah.
Or something. I don't know, man. It's just weird. I don't know. So.
Well, I mean, so here's the thing. If you think of how much money they spent on R&D on this machine, you think that if there was a better way to do it, that they wouldn't have figured it out?
No, like, that's fun. Yeah, no. That's what I'm saying, too, is like a lot of the times it's like when you people that mod their cars, It's like, bro, like, I'll mod the shit out of my cars, too.
But when you mod your cars, you're actually changing the performance. You're changing the airflow, or you're changing the horsepower, something.
I wonder how much if the performance drops if you're putting a washer mod. What is the difference going to change? Is it really going to... I think it's going to be the longevity of your polisher.
The balance, for one. So if this is engineered to work at peak performance this way, and you put any variance, even if you change it from a 6 to a 5, you throw off the balance.
Bro, I haven't noticed any difference.
Yeah.
But...
Yeah. No, I'm with you. So
I don't know.
For me, it's the cooling factor. Like
the cooling factor didn't make sense to me, but I'm just saying, like, dude, this thing is so sick, bro. It does suck that it's white. Didn't they do a red batch?
Was a long time ago. That was for something else. He did it. He bought those and then had them painted afterwards.
Dude, it's already dirty, bro. Yeah. My freaking hands just dirtied it all up. Bro, look at that. Yeah. God damn it. I didn't wash my hands good enough.
Oh, we coat it. We have to coat it. I wonder if a coating would stick on that.
Yeah, it seems pretty porous.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. But
plastic coating.
But speaking of this, too, there's a video I want you to watch. How much easier polish has been. We should pull it up real quick. Pull it up.
If you're a beginner in the world of car detailing...
So this video, it's not so much the dude.
Out there. And that's all well and good because each one has its own strengths and weaknesses. But if you're a beginner, it can...
This dude just sounds like you look at it and he's like, they just make it when they put like a British dude on here or whatever. It just sounds extra official. It
sounds like he knows what he's talking about and he probably doesn't.
Just by watching him. I know for a fact that Jason would be pissed if you'd seen how much compound he just puts on his pad when he pulled it up.
But that's so.
Polishing cars have never been
easier.
I would agree with that.
Would you disagree with that?
No, I don't disagree with that.
It's not. Let's not get it twisted. That doesn't mean that it's not like you still need to be a skilled trained technician to do it at peak performance. Like, there's a difference between being able to get results and getting professional level results, right? Most people can jump on one of these machines and get results, but it may take the amateur or the DIY guy, you know, 3-4 times longer to get half the results, but they'll still get results. But
yeah, it's definitely like to do a car from, if you're really doing paint correction, like whatever you're doing, like a paint correction, I'm not talking about enhancement, I'm not talking about anything. You full from great wash, like how long's a good wash? 45 minutes. Wheels by itself is going to take you to do a wheel good 5 minutes of wheel. Yep. Is that right?
At least 5 minutes if you're freaking Superman.
Oh, hell yeah. Young Camo is enough in the house right here. 7 today. I had him go pick us up some.
What is this?
Dude, I told him to go just get some Jamba. So that's a Caribbean passion. Do you like Jamba?
Yeah, I love Jamba.
I know it has a lot of sugar.
I love sugar.
But here, dude, here,
sugar my weakness. Are they all the same?
No. I got a strawberry one. Of course. Strawberry banana. And I got you guys Caribbean passions.
All right, here, take that. Thanks, man.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
I was like, dude, I have to get it. But anyway, so what we're saying is to do wheels 20 minutes or minimum of 20 minutes.
A wheel in most cases.
Wheel wells, like, I mean, that's not if it's dirty, bro. Like, it's a lot of work.
I'm sorry, I gotta say, like, your expectations, like how quick you guys get it done to how quick the regular world does are very different, two different things. You guys got stuff really dialed, so it's, you know, I mean, it takes me twice as long to clean a wheel typically than you guys can knock them out.
You don't think, like, 5 minutes a wheel?
Mm-mm. No way.
How much? 10 minutes a wheel?
10, 15 minutes a wheel. Yeah. I mean, you can speed that up with the right chemistry and if you're doing things right, yeah, for sure. But preparation, man, you figure most people, that's where a lot of people drop the balls. They don't prepare. So they make 15 trips over to grab the stuff that they need instead of just spending a few minutes getting it ready. Having, like, you have your buckets dialed in with everything that you need for the job.
Be efficient.
Man, and that's me, man. I forget 15 things and I run 3 miles to do a wheel because I'm going back and forth trying to get the stuff that I forgot.
Like, efficiency problem, that's probably always my nemesis. Like, I have a way now, I have a process, so that made me efficient. My process made me efficient, not necessarily having everything at an arm's reach.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, like, doing something consistent over of, I don't know, whatever, 10,000 hours of polishing. I don't even know how many hours of polishing, but some crazy amount of polishing, that's what made me faster and kind of like being lazy and be like, oh, well, I got to get it done this way. I got to do, you know, cutting different
trial and error, like, experience, man.
But dude, polishing is, dude, the game has changed every single time. And obviously AMMO is one of the people that educates, like, crazy education and helps everyone make more money.
Yeah.
Because he goes in depth of how everything's, you know, how in depth and how much work goes involved with everything, that when someone calls me, if they're one of those people, enthusiasts that are watching YouTube, they know, like, right off the bat, like, yo, they want it done right, this is what it's going to cost.
Right.
This is what it's going to take. And there's no sticker shock.
Right.
At least anymore.
In that.
There still is. But if someone's educated about paint correction and actually want their paint enhanced, they're not, the sticker shock isn't the same because they know how much work goes into
it. Yeah. But, I mean, the thing is there's not just one way to do it. Like, his way is, he goes all out, you know, there's nothing he skips. But there's, like, that's not the only way to do it. You know what I mean? Like, everyone, as long as you're proficient, you get customer-pleasing results, your customers are happy, and you're making dough, like, there's 50, yeah, you know,
you need it all. Like,
a thousand,
honestly,
ways to skin a cat,
it's,
you know?
You know, when you have even, like, this, the boutique style or the, if that's the kind of shop you are, then it's more about the customer experience than your work.
Right.
You know? Yeah, dude, it's crazy. This is awesome, bro. This shit's so dope.
Yeah. I'm
not gonna use it. I'm gonna just put it at home. I'll use it at the house. Probably maybe get a new
start a little collection.
Yeah, I gotta get another one of those.
I know a guy.
Yeah, I need.
I'll bring you one next time.
Yeah. Let's get it. Yep. So anyways, bro, like,
so
honestly, so I think it was like, what was the price? I think it was like $800 for all this. I feel like it's a pretty fair.
It's actually compound. Not bad. It's like, not a if bad. If you were to piece all this stuff out on your own, it probably would come close to that,
pretty close to that, you know. What do you think? Good. These towels seem legit.
So
these are actually made in Jamaica. Just joking. Jamaican fiber.
that's the new standard. Polishing, you've been in the game for a long time. You've seen kind of the iteration or the evolution of polishing. Like, would you say that polishing is easier now than it's ever been?
Yeah, chemicals, everything about the industry, the innovation that's came in is crazy. Like, you know, from, dude, iron remover, bro.
Yeah.
Like, just off of that by itself, like, you know, it's like claying a car is easier. Perforated clay mitts.
Do you feel like
clay towels?
Yeah.
Like, everything is everything, bro. Like, everything
the
about
liquids,
it.
The liquids, the pads, the machines, like, everything.
And the thing about it is, I think it's just begun. Like, I feel like real money is really understanding. It's like, yo, the market in this is to make money. It's like, bro, like, who just goes and buys this?
right?
Just you to, know, just like, yo, this is dope. Like, because people want to buy it. Like, uh-huh. They're like, dude, I guarantee, I don't even know how many he sold. So if he sold 1,000 of them at $100 a pop.
1,000 of them at 800?
No, sorry. He sold 1,000 at $1,000. How much is that?
That's
it's a lot of fucking money.
I can't even count that high. 100,000,
like,
that's a mil. Seven figures.
He probably made a mil.
Oh, dude, I'm sure
you
he sold 1,000.
You think he sold more than 1,000?
Yeah, probably.
Damn, dude.
Right? When you break it down, that's crazy, man.
1,000. He made, I bet you in that day, he sold at least 1,000.
At least within that seven-day stretch, because it's been a week since it's been out.
How many of them? How many of these have you seen online? Who else has done reviews of them?
I've seen a bunch. I've probably seen 15 of them myself. But think about it, dude. Like, think of all the guys that are going to buy this and go and do their Corvette in their driveway, and their neighbor's going to see it, and like, this is going to open the door for them. So that 1,000 is going to continue to accelerate. Like, he's going to.
He got a customer for life, bro.
Yeah.
You know, even all them dudes. So I'm excited. I'm excited to put this to work, do a little bit of work on it.
Going back to what we were saying, though, about polishing being easier, like, there are some cats that push back on the kind of the new way to do things. They kind of hate on it, right? Mm-hmm. Do you think that they're hating because they're, like, afraid that people are going to catch up, or that, like, that newcomers are going to come in and have an easier path? Or, like, why do you think... Like,
no, I just think... I think a lot of detailers... insecure. Mm-hmm. Like, dude, it's still a lot of work. Like, you can get a coolest tool ever, but it's a lot of work. Mm-hmm.
And there's enough work for,
like,
everyone.
There's enough work, but it's like, you can't pretend. There's no pretending and detailing. You can go and be cute, take some pictures in front of some nice cars.
You're only going to be cute for so long.
Yeah, I mean, bro, but it's work. So, yeah, like, yeah. In order for you to really, really get money, it's like you're busting your ass.
People don't, some detailers hate on this influx. We have this influx, like, detailers come in that, you know, there's a low barrier to entry, and then they wash out and they hate, like, oh, you know, they're another new detailer. But they don't realize that every new detailer that gets in the game brings a handful of customers, their friends and their family.
They're educating,
they
bro. They're soldiers. They're out here educating.
If I get into the industry, okay, and I get 15, 20 people that I know, my friends and family, to understand and, like, appreciate detailing, and then I leave the industry, what does that leave?
You
10 to 15 people that exactly. Now are going to go and find other detailers. So, like, they're just creating more, yeah, education. They're educating consumers. And, like, man, there's just people hate for no reason. Like, it's, I don't know. There's enough for everyone.
Well, the thing is, they just have too much time on their hands.
Right, because they don't have enough work.
Like, they don't have no work. It's like, yeah, let's go criticize someone that's working. All right, well, shoot, let's pull up this other video. Speaking of haters, this is another guy that gets quite a bit of heat.
Anticipated video.
Oh, man. This is pretty dope.
Bro.
Did you watch the...
His awards? I did.
Yeah, the awards.
I did, man. I don't understand the hate. Like, I honestly love Pam the Organizer, but I met him in person. I went to the Coach Kemi's event for experts last year in Atlanta at the Porsche.
Yeah. Yeah,
whatever.
Yeah, you told me that. Yeah.
And he was there. And honestly, bro, Pan is dope. Like, he's a smart guy. He really knows what he's doing. He's really personable in person. And in fact, like, me and him talked about the Rupes had just launched their microfiber pads, and I asked him if he had tried them. We were talking. I mean, we talked for a few hours. He's a really cool guy. And later, like, he's like, no, I haven't tried them. So, like, 3 months later, when he actually got around to trying them and he did a review video on it, bro, he gave me a shout out. He's like, yeah, I talked to this kid, Shad. He told me about these pads. And I mean, like, you know what I mean? A million followers. We met for 15 minutes, and he's like, he's a good dude.
It's always cool when people give you the time of day.
Yeah, well, he's so,
like,
down to earth.
From what I heard, I don't know, like, people say, yo, this guy's pretty cool. I just think it's dope that he goes, because I don't have the time to, like, go and, like, find every product. So, yeah, and I will go to I do go to YouTube. Like, I am a professional, and I'll try stuff, and I'm not going to, like, co-sign on anything, but I like to go and watch videos and, like, oh, this dude tried the 3D this, or he tried this, or laters, bro. You know, so he tried all this stuff, and then I want to go and try it for myself.
Yeah.
You know, I'm all about trying.
It's a good entry. Cool. But don't take it at gospel, you know what I mean? Go, like, do your own research. Like, if you see something that interests you, like, educate yourself on it. But, yeah, dude, I love Pan. I think he's great for the industry.
Have you tried that? Have you tried the G-Technique? Any of the G-Technique stuff?
Yeah, yeah.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, it's good, man.
Koch Kemi,
GSF. Love. They were, you know, he talks about that belt hammer stuff a lot. I wonder, have you ever tried the Coach Kemi's Super Foam? It's nasty, bro. It's like, it's nasty good. It's a, like, a pH of 12. Has a pre-soak, man. Has a prep. Ooh, that stuff is fire.
Oh, man. So, yeah. I've tried that.
DIY.
Incredible Suds. I tried that.
Bro, that's DIY.
DIY came.
They got some love. They got some love on there for sure. Like,
and I would say that they just popped out of nowhere. That's a new company.
Yeah, they've been around like less than a year.
And they just came out. So they're hitting it hard. Anyway,
people can't delineate. Dude, like professionals can't delineate that DIY and professional. Like they get hate from professionals and I'm just like, I don't understand it.
Well, because the thing is why are you even acknowledging something that called DIY?
Right.
And it's like, bro, like listen to the goddamn name.
Right.
And you're over here talking shit.
Yeah. And not that like, it's, bro, I mean, it's like, they're good. They're good products. Not that it, not, I mean, they're professional grade products, but
they're the educating, educating the culture.
Yep.
Detailing culture needs that. We need people to keep on educating. Because no matter what people, they don't understand. No one knows what a paint correction is. So when you detailers go and call me on the phone and you ask, you're trying to get me price shopping and talk about clay and decontamination. I know, like,
that you know.
Bro, you're not, like, no one knows that. I don't have no customers ever ask me about a freaking paint correction unless they're like, and the people that do ask, they're like, yo, I'm going to come to your shop. Let's see what you're about and let's dial in it like that. No one knows about a paint correction. No one even, barely people know about a ceramic coating.
Mm-hmm. Until you tell
them. Can you give me a nice coat of wax? You know, I heard that today. Like, bro. I'll put some wax on it.
Yeah.
You know, like, I don't even, sometimes we'll educate and we'll tell them, say, look, this is what it is. Mm-hmm. But sometimes it doesn't even go. It's like, you got the sale already. Like, why are you trying to take the money from yourself? You know what I mean? Just like, all right, cool. You want it? We got it. This is better than that.
Right.
This is what, as a professional, this is what I think you should do. And they're going to be like, yes, sir.
Yeah. What are they going to say? No, I know better. Like, I mean, you'll get one of those dudes every once in a while.
What, you watching AMMO all day? What? You don't got a job? You're not watching.
How are you going to pay for this?
You don't watching Pan, bro? Yeah. What you watching? So, yeah, dude, it's been crazy.
You still get guys that call and price shop you like that trying to.
Yeah, I think not like so much right now, but I would say like April. March, April, when people are like, oh, I'm starting my company.
Which, like, let me ask you this. So you get cats that call you and they're like, oh, hey, they're trying to act like they're a customer, right? They're trying to get your pricing. If somebody called you and was just straight up be like, look, dude, I'm just getting into the industry. Like, instead of trying this half-assed approach to try and call you to get the information, if they called and said, hey, man, I'm just getting into the industry. Could you give me, is there something I can do? Could I add value to you some way? Can I come and like do something for you or add value and you can walk me through pricing?
I would help in a heartbeat.
You'd probably be like, you don't even have to go and do that. Just the thought of you doing that, just the adding value in that way, you'd be like, yeah, let me walk you, I'll tell you. But you get somebody calls you and
I would help them, bro. Like if someone just comes, like I've had people do that. They come down, like I'll put them to work.
Yeah.
It's like, what, man, you want some work? Like what? Let's go. You know what I mean? Like, come on, let's get it. So yeah, no, people are still doing that, and it's weird, it's
funny,
but I get it. You know, everybody's trying to just level up. You know, everyone's trying to get paid, so I can't. You know, it's funny.
It defeats the like they're getting the opposite. They're not going to get the information that way. Trying to be sneaky about it, like just be upfront about it. Like a lot of people like to take. They want something for free. Like instead of trying to add, we talked about it a little bit last week. Add value. Give value and then ask. It's the same with your customers, man. Give your customers value and then ask for some referrals and then ask for some more vehicles. Don't say, oh, you got five vehicles. Let me do them all. Say, let me do one. Let me show you what I got. And then after you add value, then, hey, let me get those other four vehicles.
You have that. If you're not that busy and you get that one customer, most likely, you know, I'm going to send a friend. You don't want that, dude. But you want to knock it out of the park because you don't want to count on that referral. You just want to get an email, create a relationship, shoot the dude a text.
Add
in
value.
2 weeks.
Yeah.
Like, who cares about?
Follow up.
Let's make a friend. Let's make a, you know.
Make a fan.
Make a fan. Make a friend, whatever. He's your customer. You want to knock it out of the park. Just add stuff. Even like your stuff you're going to already do. Like, oh, you know, I decided to put a ceramic or a ceiling on your windshield. Even though they didn't pay for it, whatever, ceramic ceiling. Just do it. It's like, it's going to help out. You know, just throw these little things and you're going to do it anyway. Like,
yeah. But like, don't give away the boat. Like, if it, don't give them the three-step correction if they're paying for the enhancement.
No, no,
you know
don't
I mean?
Do don't do anything like that, obviously.
But do the enhancement.
Do what they want right. and then just throw your twist on it.
Yeah, customer, do a little bit yeah. extra. Just a little yeah. bit. It doesn't take, you don't have to do a full interior, you know, seven-hour job if they're paying for a wipe down, yeah, you know what yeah. I mean? But they're do a little bit extra.
That's it.
You got a business that way. But those are three, like, those were three dimes right there that you just said, man. But follow up, like, you have to follow up. Like, even after the job is done, like, you have to continue to follow up to stay top of mind for those people. Because guess what? If you call someone and say, hey, or hit them up 2 weeks later, hey, how's everything going? Just want to touch base. You have anything else? Even if they don't have something for you, when their buddy 2 weeks later asks, hey, man, you know anyone? You're going to be top of mind. You're going to be a person. Oh, no, but guess what? I know I just had my car done. Like, keep yourself top of mind.
Yeah, you never know. He might be one of those friends when he gets into his buddy's car. He's like, damn, bro. You need a detail. Yeah. Bro, this thing is nasty, bro. Like, call my boy, you know? Like, come on. Right. Like, I don't know. I think, you know, creating a relationship, you know, treating people good is always, there's nothing. There's nothing's going to ever come bad.
No. Absolutely. No, relationships. Good, but, like, going back to what I was just saying, man, like, people, like, to create a relationship, you have to add value. You can't just give. It has to be a give and receive. Not even a give and take. It's a give and receive. Like, you have to add value before you ask. Like, and people just get that twisted. People just want to, they just expect to, like, to take.
Yeah, I don't even realize I'm selling anymore. Like, honestly, when someone comes in, I'm just like, I'm just literally there helping. Like, and they happen to.
You're their guide.
I'm guiding, yeah, yep. Exactly. I'm coming in, hey, how are you? Oh, this. I'm not even trying to upsell. Oh yeah, we do dance. We do paint touch. Oh my gosh. We do this. I'm there.
The guy, dude, that is so important, bro. Because this is where a lot of guys mess up. Is they try to be the hero. Like, I'm the hero. I know everything. I'm the detailer. You need to be the guide. The customer is the hero. You need to be their guide. You need to be Yoda to Luke Skywalker. Don't be the hero. No one gives you shit about all your accolades or all the Lamborghinis. They don't care. Like, be the guy. Don't be the hero. The customer is the hero. You make the customer the hero every time, yes. And you be the guide. You will be their guide forever. Like,
bro, I have customers, like, that call me for, like, yard work, bro. Like, hey, do you got a little yard guard? You know this? You know, at first I was getting mad. I was like, bro, you saying that because I'm Mexican? I just know I got them to connect, you know? But no, it's not that. It's like they really trust. They trust like, you, they yeah. trust you. Yeah. And it's like, yo, he knows what's good. He wants, you know... He's around people that want to do good jobs. Maybe he has this. And bro, like I've connected like real estate agents with construction, with contractors, with tile guys, to this guy, to electrician, to plumber, blah, blah, blah. These are all like friends, you know, these 10 friends that I just put together and they all have common of me. And guess what? Now everyone's, yep. you know.
Same thing. Well, it's relationships because then when they get asked about detailing or how do I, you know, when they get asked about car stuff, Who do they send their people to? You.
Yeah.
Because you have that relationship. It's a give and receive.
And I have detailer buddies. I have friends around me, not within like a mile, that I send work to like regularly. Because, and vice versa. Like, they can get it done, like, I'll send it.
Yeah.
Because we can't do it all.
No. You can try, but...
Yeah, you got... Unless you can take work that day with the shops that are available the day of... Those shops would kill it, you know?
Yeah.
That's the way to be. You got to be, if a lot of detail shops, yeah, it's cool to be booked out, but you want to be able to have guys, you know, and then you can charge more.
Right.
It's like, because, you know, this guy's booked, well, $500 for an detail, cool.
Because they need it. That's the thing. They need it right now.
That's the thing is, detailing's a luxury, but the people that get detailing's because they're pigs, bro.
Right.
Like, they need it.
Bro, what you just said was so huge. What? Like, so huge. Well, just having that separation. People think, like, people probably took from that and thought, oh, I have to, like, you're saying that if I'm booked out and I have to also take same day appointments. No, you have the availability or the ability to take same day appointments at a higher rate. So even if it's twice, if your normal shop rate is $100 an hour and you take the same day appointment at double, like, man.
Dude, people are fine with that.
Yeah.
Double. Because if you're booked out, they're going to call the next, and it's kind of, you know, it kind of gets tired. Well, finally, someone answered. I'm going to do it. Let's do it. You yeah. know?
So they'll pay more.
And it's cool. Like, book out schedule, because like I said, I did that. That's fine. But I feel like the people that really can kill it in this is going to be the dudes that have like a full system shops. Like, come and get in.
And don't get it twisted. Like, just by charging more for that same day, you're not, like, gouging the customer. Because, again, like, you have to have, like, setups to be able to perform that on the same day. You know what I mean? So it's a wrench in your system to do that. But, like, you're still at, you're giving value. Even though you're charging more, that's still value from them because they need it done, right? That day for a reason. So you're not, like, doing them a disservice by charging them more. Like,
your service is, we did it same day.
So this,
you know,
is
like,
the, this,
this
is
what it is. Mm-hmm. And I'm pretty sure they're going to be happy with it and everything's going to be good. But yeah, man, we just rambled off again.
I didn't even see that.
We just rambled off. Oh, what is that?
You see the buff? They got the, Ammo's got the Buff Daddy.
Buff Daddy?
Buff
Put
Daddy
that, hold it up to the
signature
camera.
Signature of approval on the back here.
Who's Buff Daddy?
Kevin Brown?
I don't know who Buff Daddy is.
Kevin Brown. This cat, I've seen videos of this guy polishing and doing paint correction with lotion.
Paint correction with lotion?
Yeah.
That's dope.
Kevin Brown.
And I believe you probably can, you know, if you have the right combination pad, you probably can get it done.
Yeah. He's funny, yeah.
See, dude, I got to get online more, man, because I'm out of touch when it comes to some of these dudes. But yeah, so let's,
Well, just talking about relationships, man. Like, I ran into a video earlier today or yesterday that caught my attention that I wanted to run through real quick, just kind of since we were talking about that.
We surround ourselves around people that make us feel great. They tell us what we want to hear. The second we put ourselves amongst the uncommon people, we don't like that feeling, that challenging feeling of that person who's waking up at 3:30 in the morning and saying, hey, put your shit on, we're going for a run. We don't like that challenge. We like that person who says, hey, you know what, man, I don't feel good today, man. And they say, oh, it's okay, brother. We'll take a day off, man. We'll get a pizza and watch the
today.
Game. We love that feeling. Why? Because you understand, man, we're good, bro. We don't want that motherfuckers like this. Hey, man, no, bro. Get your fucking shit on, man. Stop being a punk. Like a lot of guys who graduate buzz, graduate this, graduate that, they get comfortable. They wonder why I'm getting weak, man. I don't know. I lost my edge. Because once you hit the top of the fucking mountain, guess what happened? I'm good. You're mediocre now, man. What are you fucking doing today, tomorrow, the next fucking day? You gain knowledge through suffering. And on the other end of suffering is a world that very few have ever seen. It's a beautiful world because that's where you find yourself.
Bro, suffering.
No.
That's it, man.
Dude.
But
I'm tired. Look, let me just say this because I did. This is the first time I hear it. Now you've heard it before. I'm tired every day, bro. Bro, I'm keeping it real with you. Every day. I'm tired every day. But guess what? We're here to get it.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, bro, like, you...
Bro, but people just touch on what he said. People want to avoid suffering more than they want to be happy. They will avoid suffering to the fullest extent. Like, it's more important. The avoidance of suffering is more important than happiness to most people. Like, not realizing that the suffering is what creates the happiness. Like, you can't grow. You have to be uncomfortable. Growth always follows discomfort. And discomfort, suffering is always uncomfortable. Like, it's never, like, comfortable, but that's the only way you can grow. But what kind of linked that together was what he was talking about, like, the people you surround yourself with. We were talking about relationships, man. And I know you've probably heard this before, and a lot of people have, but, like, you're kind of the sum total of the five people that you spend your most time with. And that's not even like living people or people that you actively spend time with. That's like if you are reading books or if you like are watching content of somebody people like David Goggins, like that's the info you're getting, like that's how you that's a great way to level up. But you have to get through the discomfort. You have to get through the suffering. And people just run around avoiding suffering, not realizing that happiness is on the other side of that, man. That's how you grow.
Dude, it's just like the gym. When you work out hard and you leave sore, then you did something.
You can't. Your
life is like that. You gotta, dude. If the pain is where the growth is at.
Yep. Your muscles can't grow until you tear those bitches. Like that's the only way you grow. It's the suffering, man. So that just caught my attention. I love that. David Goggins is an absolute beast.
That was that was a good way to end this, bro. I'm pumped, bro. Like I was gonna actually go home after this, but now I'm gonna go work more.
I'm gonna
get some shit done.
To the gym.
Yeah, boy. Hey, Jamie Gonzalez.
Chad Stoker.
Thank you guys for watching.
We out.
Comment. Let us know what else to talk about next time, man. Appreciate you guys.
Yep.
Thank you, brother. Again, another good day. Hell yeah.
Sure.
Woo. Oh,
damn. I'm taking this home with me and the light and all of it.
Damn.
You keep those towels, though.
I don't want those.
Or those waffle pads.